Now that we have an approved cure for sickle cell disease that does not require looking for a compatible donor, many people have been asking questions about this innovative game-changing solution called Casgevy. This video is a highly simplified explanation of how the Casgevy CRISPR-Cas9 works to cure sickle cell disease. Sickle cell disease, a hereditary blood disorder, has long posed significant challenges in the medical field due to its complex genetic nature. However, the emergence of gene editing technologies, notably CRISPR, which means clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats. Don't worry about the long name. This technology has enabled us to manipulate the gene of a sickle cell patient outside the body and return it back to the patient after the process. Thereafter, the patient will be able to produce normal red blood cells. CRISPR consists of two main components. 1. Guide RNA, which indicate the part of DNA to cut in. 2. An enzyme called Cas9, which causes a double-stranded DNA break, allowing modifications to the genome. To treat sickle cell disease using CRISPR, scientists correct the genetic mutation responsible for the abnormal hemoglobin in an indirect way. The process typically involves several steps. 1. Identifying the mutation. Scientists first pinpoint the specific gene to correct. 2. Designing the CRISPR-Cas9 system. They then design a guide RNA that matches the sequence of the gene they want to remove. This guide RNA acts as a molecular address that guides the Cas9 enzyme to the precise location of the gene to cut. 3. Isolation of patient cells. Hematopoietic stem cells are collected from the patient's bone marrow or blood. These cells have the potential to develop into various types of blood cells, including red blood cells. 4. CRISPR-Cas9 editing. In the laboratory, the isolated stem cells are exposed to CRISPR-Cas9 along with a specific guide RNA designed to target the specific gene to remove. Once inside the cell, the Cas9 enzyme, guided by the guide RNA, precisely cuts the DNA at the targeted location or gene. You might be wondering, which gene are we removing from the stem cells? Before we explain this, let's understand hemoglobin a little more. There are three main types of normal hemoglobin, which are 1. Hemoglobin A, found in adults, 2. Hemoglobin A2, also found in adults, and 3. Hemoglobin F, also known as fetal hemoglobin, which is found in fetus during pregnancy and in early life. People with sickle cell disease can produce the normal type of hemoglobin called hemoglobin F, but the production goes down shortly after birth as a result of the function of a gene called BCL11A. BCL11A functions mainly as a transcriptional repressor that is crucial in fetal to adult hemoglobin switching. Meaning if we can remove this gene, the sickle cell disease patients will continue to produce the fetal hemoglobin, which is a normal hemoglobin. Now this is where the innovation in Casgevy comes to play. Casgevy is used to target this BCL11A gene, so that the Cas9 enzyme cuts both DNA strands to inactivate the BCL11A gene. Remember that BCL11A usually prevents the production of a form of good hemoglobin that we call fetal hemoglobin. By disrupting this gene, Casgevy unleashes the production of fetal hemoglobin, which is a good hemoglobin. Note that, when the DNA is cut, the cell's natural repair mechanisms come into play. The next step is to select the well-edited cells and multiply them. Now we have the good edited stem cells ready for use and we can proceed to the next step, which is infusion of corrected cells. The edited cells are reintroduced into the patient's body through a transplant procedure. These modified cells can produce healthy red blood cells, thus reducing or eliminating the symptoms of sickle cell disease. Before the gene-edited cells are infused back into the body, the patient must undergo a treatment that prepares the bone marrow to receive the modified cells. Once administered, the stem cells give rise to red blood cells containing fetal hemoglobin. This relieves symptoms by boosting the oxygen supply to tissues. Patients may need to spend at least a month in a hospital facility while the treated cells take up residence in the bone marrow and start to make red blood cells with the stable form of hemoglobin. If you find value in this video, kindly subscribe to our channel so that you can be notified anytime we release a new video. Note that knowledge is advancing by the day and we will like to always post an update on new advances on how to stay healthy. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel and listening to work of Dr. Kayode.